Hello everyone. Today we're going to be doing a hip twist series. So you just need your mat and a towel to support your head for this one. So we're going to lie on our backs to get ourselves set up to start with. Okay, so we will make sure that we've got feet and knees hip width apart. And then I'm just going to do a couple of pelvic tilts just so that I can find that neutral position. Engage the abdominals. Pull them in a little bit, shoulders are nice and relaxed. Okay, so today we are going to do our hip twist series, starting with a basic hip twist and then gradually building it up to a more difficult hip twist exercise. So I'm just going to have my arms just out to the side a little bit, just so they're out of the way. We're just going to start with one leg moving. So on this first one, it's all about keeping the abdominals pulled in nicely so that we're keeping the pelvis nice and still. So we're going to take a breath in on this one as we send the knee out to the side. And then breathing out, we're going to bring it back up to the center. And again on the other side, breathing, knee goes out. And breathe out as it comes back up. And again, breathing in. And breathing out. So we just want to make sure on this first one that everything is staying nice and still around the center. Don't want any movements. So the legs don't have to go out too far, a little bit is fine. Wonderful, we'll make that one our last one. Okay, nice easy one to start with. Now let's make it a little bit more challenging. So on this next one, we're going to bring the legs together. So we've got ankles and knees glued together this time. We don't want to let those legs slip apart. We are going to straighten out one leg, okay? So we've still got the knees glued together. We're going to send the legs just over to one side a few times and then we'll do on the other side. So we're going to take a breath in to prepare. And then as we breathe out, we're going to send the legs over. Let's hold it for breath in. And then breathe out as we come back up. Breath into the hair again. Let's go the same way again. Breathing out, legs go over. Hold it for a breath in. Breathe out, come back up. Now you'll notice I'm only sending my legs about halfway down to the floor. Don't really want to take them any further than that because I want to control the movements. Okay? And with that leg out straight, if we take it too far to the floor, it's going to make it quite challenging to bring them back up to center. Wonderful. Okay, done five. Let's do five on the other side. So knees stay super glued together. Straighten out the other leg. Here we go again. Breathing out. Send the legs over. Hold for a breath in. Breathe out. Return. And again, breathe out. Legs go over. Breath in to hold. And return. Off we go again. Wonderful. So keep the knees super glued together. Okay. I think we're almost there. I think we'll make this next one our last one. Wonderful. Let's bring that foot back down. I'm going to find the feet out again. Okay. So the feet and knees are hip width again. Now, this time we're going to float one leg up. Now, this exercise, it seems quite easy at first, but actually it's quite challenging. We're just going to be moving one leg, but you've really got to focus on keeping those abdominals engaged so that you keep the pelvis completely still. You could have your hands on the hips for this one, just so that you can check yourself, make sure there's no movement. Okay, so we're going to take a breath in this time as the leg goes out to the side. And then breathe out as it comes back up to the ceiling. And again, breathing in and breathing out. So again, don't make that movement too big. It needs to be nice and controlled so we keep the pelvis nice and still. Now a little tip for you, the foot that's on the floor, if you push that foot into your mat, that will just help to stabilize you a little bit. Let's just do one more. Wonderful. Let's do it on the other leg. So here we go again. We're going to breathe in as the leg goes out to the side and breathe out as it comes back up. Breathing in and breathing out. So you might find now that one side feels more challenging than the other. That's quite normal. We're often quite stronger on one side than the other side, so that's okay. Here we go, we'll make this one our last one. Wonderful. Now, let's bring both legs up into double tabletop this time. So we'll take them up. Okay, now I'm going to keep the legs together. So I've got knees together, ankles together. The abdominals are pulled in really well. Okay, so I don't lose that neutral position. Okay, now arms are out to the side again. Let's move just one leg again. So we're going to breathe in as the leg goes out to the side. And breathe out as it comes back up. Breathe in, and the leg goes out to the side. And then bring it back up. Now you might actually find that this one is a little bit easier than the previous one, even though both legs are up in the air. Okay. In some ways, it does feel a little bit easier. Okay, just one more on each side. Here's the last one. Wonderful. Okay, let's lower those legs down for a second. We've just got one more to do. We're going to bring them back up into double tabletop position. We're going to move both legs together this time. We'll do a different breathing pattern again on this one. So let's bring the legs up. So we're going to take a breath in to prepare. And then keep those legs together as you breathe out and send them over to the side just a little bit. Hold it there for breath in. And then breathe out as you bring the knees back up to center. Let's go the other way. Breathe out, knees go over to the side just a little bit. Hold it for a breath in. And then breathe out as you come back to center. Wonderful. Off we go again. Now make sure you've got knees and ankles staying together the whole time. So you're going to feel one hip lifting up off the mat as those legs go over. Let's just do one more on each side. Breathing out, breath in to hold. And return, last time. And bring the back in. Wonderful. Let's hug the knees into the chest for a second. Okay, now those are our five exercises. Now that you're familiar with them, you know what we're doing. Let's put them all together. So we'll still have a little breather in between each one, but we'll try and keep it moving a little bit more than this time. Okay, so let's start with that basic hip twist again. So we've got feet and knees hip width apart. The arms are out to the side again. I'm engaging through the abdominals to keep the pelvis nice and still. So we're going to take a breath in as one knee goes out to the side. And then breathe out as it comes back up. And on the other leg, breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in and breathing out. Wonderful. So your focus should just be on keeping the pelvis as still as possible. So it doesn't matter if that knee doesn't go out too far. It's more important that we keep that pelvis nice and still. Here we go. Last one. Wonderful. Okay, bring the legs together, knees and ankles together. We're going to straighten out one leg. We'll change the breathing pattern again for this one. So we'll take a breath in to prepare. And as you breathe out, the legs go over no more than halfway. Then hold it for a breath in. Breathe out as you bring the legs back up. We're going to go the same way again. Breathing out, legs go over to the side. Hold it for a breath in. And then breathe out as they come back up. And again, breathing out. Breath in to hold. And return. Wonderful. Off we go again. So really feel like you're drawing in the abdominals a little bit more as you bring those legs back up to the center. Wonderful. That's the last one. Let's switch the legs over. Knees together again. Breathing out. Legs go over to the side. Hold for a breath in. Breathe out as they come back up. And again, breathing out, legs go over. And again on this one, you'll also feel one hip lifting up off the mat as you send those legs over. Okay, so make sure the knees stay together, and then you'll get that little lift through the hip as well. Here we go, last one. Breathing out, breath into hold, and breathe out to return. Wonderful, let's lower that leg down. We're going to fan the feet out again. Okay, this time we're going to float one leg up. Hold it there. So again, keeping the pelvis nice and still this time, we're going to take a breath in as the leg moves out to the side, and breathe out as it comes back to center. And again, breathing in and breathing out. Wonderful. Okay, so just check that the pelvis is staying nice and still. Make sure you've still got those abdominals pulled in really well. Don't let them dome, so feel like you're sucking the navel down towards the mat. Okay, here we go. Last one. Fabulous. Okay, let's switch legs. Off we go again. Breathing in, leg goes over to the side and returns. Wonderful. Keeping that pelvis nice and still again. Doing a really good job. Let's just do two more. Breathing in and breathing out. Last one and return. Wonderful. We'll keep that leg there because we're going to pick the other leg up. Okay, both legs come up. Okay, so make sure you're in neutral. Don't let that lower back arch. Keep the abdominals pulled in. Don't let them pop out. Okay, let's move just one leg out to the side again. So as we breathe in, one leg goes out. And then bring it back to center. Other leg goes out and bring it back to center. Breathing in, breathing out. Nice and controlled. Nice and steady. Just taking the leg out as far as you want to. Wonderful. I think we'll just do one more. On each side. Wonderful. Okay, let's bring the legs down just for a second. We're going to take the legs back up into double tabletop this time, but we're going to bring them together so we can take both legs over to the side together. Okay, so bring the legs up one at a time. Knees and ankles together in neutral, abdominals pulled in. So we're going to take a breath in to prepare. And as you breathe out, we're going to send the knees over just a little bit. Knees, ankles stay together, remember. Holding for a breath in. And then breathe out to bring them back up. Then we go the other way. Breathe out, knees go over to the side. Hold for a breath in. Breathe out, bring them back up to center. And the other way. Breathing out. Off we go again. Breathing out. Wonderful, we're almost there. So just check now that you're keeping those abdominals pulled in really well. If you're starting to get a little bit tired, you could just bring the knees in a little bit closer to the chest. That will make it a little bit easier, and it'll keep that low back nice and supported in a good position. Here we go, last one, going the other way. Breathing out, breath into hold. And then come back to center. Wonderful. From here, we'll just hug the knees into the chest. And then we're going to have to finish with a full body release. So legs out nice and straight. Arms out overhead. Nice big stretch through the length of the body. And then we can release the arms, bring the feet back in, and we're all done.